Good morning, this is Angela with Parkrose Permaculture. It's another drizzly day in Portland, Oregon. Although I cannot complain, so much of the West Coast is facing some serious drought issues, not just the West Coast, but the whole West of the United States and Central America. And I'm really grateful for any rain that we have here, and I want to make an upcoming video about permaculture and drought and strategies for water usage. So that's definitely upcoming. Something that you might not think I need here in a rainy climate, but we are actually struggling with drought here as well. Insufficient snowpack and insufficient rainfall. So we all need to plan for water conservation for this year and beyond. So I'll definitely be doing a video on that. But for today, I actually am going to be opening a package that came in the mail. I'm super excited about it. So this, I know what it is. This is a certification plaque for the National Wildlife Federation, certifying my yard as a wildlife habitat. So I want to talk you through the 5 things you need to get certified as a National Wildlife Federation habitat and some of the benefits, but also why is it important for us to go through these kinds of programs in the first place. My yard is also a certified backyard wildlife habitat. I am a silver level. I went through that process and found it really valuable. And I'll put a link in the description to backyard habitat certification and to the National Wildlife Habitat Certification programs. So as humans in a society that is constantly shrinking habitat for wildlife, we can turn our own yards into places that provide habitat. And it's good to let people know that we don't need to feel bleak and we don't need to feel hopeless about shrinking wild spaces. It's definitely something we need to face, but also we can create pockets of habitat that support local wildlife right out our back doors or our front doors. So let's open this and then I'm gonna talk about the 5 ways that you can meet the criteria. I love that the mailer is totally compostable. There's only 1 piece of tape on the whole thing, so that's nice. I'll be able to remove that. I don't actually know what this looks like, so we're gonna find out. Oh, cute. So it's a metal plaque. This is gonna go on my grape arbor with my pesticide-free zone plaque and my backyard habitat certification plaque. This says, certified wildlife habitat. This property is recognized for its commitment to sustainably provide the essential elements of wildlife habitat. So let's talk about the 5 things that you need to do to qualify to certify yourself for this program. And then we'll talk about why I think it's important to do programs like this. So there are 5 things that we need to provide in order to qualify for this program. Number 1, food. You need a source of food for wildlife. And that can be putting out feeders. It can be growing food that wildlife likes, particularly native plants. It can be creating habitat that encourages prey species to move in, so you are providing food for predators. All of those are great things. You need to provide a source of water for wildlife. That could be a stream or a pond on your property. If you live somewhere small like me, that can come in the form of a rain garden, bird baths, bee waterers. Just need to have consistent fresh water so that wildlife has a place to safely drink. Number 3, you need to provide cover. I will say, for me, this is a really important one. I live in an area, if you live in a suburban or urban area as well, cats are the biggest cause of songbird decline in North and South America. It's right up there with habitat destruction. Millions of songbirds are killed every year by domestic cats. And we have got to provide shelter, cover, safe places for birds to hide from this invasive predator. As adorable as cats are, and yes, they may be mousers, they also are a real problem for our declining songbird populations and for amphibians and reptiles too. So providing cover in the form of growing shrubs, building structures, providing brush piles that help create microclimates and conserve moisture can help create space for amphibians. Piles of logs and sticks are places that beneficial snakes like garter snakes love to nest and overwinter. And garter snakes are great slug predators, so I will do anything and everything to encourage them in my yard. Cover, really important. Number four, you need to have places to raise young. That can come in the form of putting up birdhouses and bat boxes and owl roosts in your yard. It can come in the form of doing solitary beneficial insect houses, right? Make sure that if you are doing something like a mason bee house, you are following hygiene protocols. You can't just tack up a box full of bamboo straws and actually really support our native pollinators. You will end up setting up disease cycles. So there is definitely a hygiene protocol if you're gonna provide that kind of a place to raise young. You also can just leave all of your stocks of things up at the end of the season and piles of leaves and places like that for insects to reproduce. I definitely here create artificial shelter and places to raise young, not only in the form of structures, but also in the form of how I prune my trees and the way I stake some of my plants that creates inviting space for birds to nest and feel safe. The last thing that you need to do in order to qualify as a certified wildlife habitat is that you need to commit to using sustainable practices. There's a checklist on their website for ways that you can promote sustainability. For me, that means using no pesticides, herbicides, fungicides of any kind on my property. It means that I don't use inorganic salt fertilizers that damage the soil ecology. It means that I am not using extractive methods of caring for my yard. I'm using methods that don't promote damage to the environment and human bodies. I'm using methods that don't overuse water and other resources. And I'm using methods that promote permaculture principles. Now, you don't have to be a permaculturist to qualify for this program, but if you follow permaculture principles, you automatically will qualify for the sustainability check for this program. So why is it important to participate in programs like these? I hinted at it at the beginning, but I really, really firmly believe that it is my job to be an ambassador for permaculture, an ambassador for wildlife, an ambassador for a different way of living and being, even in an urban or suburban setting. And that we don't have to buckle and fold to the societal pressure to have a monoculture food desert lawn that requires chemical and water inputs that are not sustainable. We don't have to fit somebody else's notion of what a yard should look like that is totally out of keeping and with the way Mother Nature would do it. We can follow principles and ways of gardening that are not harming to the environment and promote space for wildlife and that are beautiful. So I do emphasize beauty a lot on this channel, even though a lot of permaculturists are really focused on function. If we want to help people feel that permaculture is approachable for them, that sustainable gardening and habitat creation is approachable for them, we have to make sure that they're not going to feel they're taking a risk in their neighborhood. They have to know that it can be beautiful and appealing and have aesthetic value. Because let's be real, humans love beauty, and we have a lot of really weird cultural expectations about what yards should look like. And if we can gently nudge people toward another way of thinking by having them stop in our front yard and like, whoa, look at the abundance here. Look at all these flowers. Look at all the fruit ripening. Look at how this design is stacked in beautifully with plants blooming in succession and arranged in a way that is visually pleasing. They'll say, maybe I could do this too and not kind of tick off everybody in my neighborhood. Maybe my lawn isn't the only way to have a pretty looking yard. So for me, letting people know that, hey, my yard is a backyard habitat. My yard is a certified wildlife habitat, but it's also really pretty and it's got lots of flowers and it's got lots of carefully landscaped beds around the front yard and the backyard, and that there is a balance to be had between beauty and wildness, and that as gardeners, we have an ability to strike that balance and bring beauty without in any way inhibiting the abundance that is possible in our garden. So for me, when folks see these signs hanging in my front yard, I hope it makes them stop and say, what is that program? What do I need to do? What changes do I need to make to qualify for something like that? I want to support native bird populations. I want to support local wildlife. How can I do that? And wow, look, this woman does it, and yet her garden is full of roses and peonies, and she's growing grapes in her front yard. And look at all of the ways in which this garden is beautiful and full of food, and whoa, also supports wildlife. So for me, I feel like it's really worth the $20 in getting certified and the additional $20 for the sign. I feel like that's a good investment. I'm supporting an organization that promotes creating and conserving wild spaces. And at the same time, I'm helping be an ambassador for wildlife in a neighborhood setting. So if you are interested in becoming a certified backyard wildlife habitat or a National Wildlife Federation wildlife habitat, I'll drop a bunch of links in the description in ways that you can certify your garden. You can make changes to your garden so that you better support wildlife. And then you can get a stamp of approval that you can share with your neighborhood, letting them know, hey, I did this thing and you can do it too. And we can have beautiful gardens and yet also support wildlife at the same time. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. There is a link below to my Patreon, as well as some of the other ways that, you know, maybe you enjoyed this video, but you don't want to become a monthly supporter. You can throw a couple of bucks in my PayPal. That would be great. That helps me make more videos and continue to produce content that you all have asked for and appreciate. So thank you so much. I'll be back soon.